any lingerie out of wool?
Cashmere.
Cashmere?
Yes.
That, no, seriously, that is really interesting because there is a woolly underwear, right? Underwear for wool. It's a big thing in Germany,
really?
Right? Yeah, no, no, I'm not making this up. It's a lady called Manuela Dankovic, and she is in Germany, and she's got this website called... Oh, there it is. It's called Wooltraum, right? Which means wool dream, right?
Perfect.
Now, this is woolen underwear, but it's for people who, like, wool fetishists, okay? Now, here are some of the happy models in their wool. You do sort of think, how cold is it in Germany? Like, so, scroll down here. There's some... Now, gimp mask or man with bird flu? You decide. There's the full-length look. Are you warm enough, dear?
I can see this taking off in Scotland. I can see that in the Dundee Ann Summers along with crotchless shell suits.
Listen, look at that. It's like having sex with a jelly baby. So now listen, the lady, Manuela, is on the line now. Hello, Manuela.
Hi, Graham.
Hello. So now, who buys this stuff? Is it mostly men?
It's different. Mostly men who buy it, but also women. Often men buy it for their women.
Yes. Can't imagine the men who buy this have women, but...
Maybe they have ugly women that they're trying to cover up.
You've sent me a box of some of the stuff.
Yes.
Which is very nice.
Uh-huh.
Now, I'm not a great knitter myself, Manuela, but even I think I could do that. It matches your suit. It matches your suit. But it has no eyes, Manuela.
Pardon?
It has no eyes.
This would be a terrifying episode of Crime Watch.
I'll have to take this pattern.
Yes. Oh, now, Elle McPherson is here. She also makes underwear.
Yes.
This is fantastic.
I'm sure I can knit things like you are producing. Probably to 80%.
All right.
It's knitted underwear.
Fantastic.
Oh, and then you put this underneath. Sorry, we're just working through.
Very sexy.
A very large blue one. Is it in a light mohair, Manuela?
Let's strip that wee guy and put him in it.
He's ginger, isn't that enough? Now, but listen, talk me through this one, because this is, I think, this is for men. So this is a willy warmer built into...
Oh, that's
some sturdy underwear. Am I right?
Fantastic.
And then I'm so glad. Do you know what I mean? Because how often do you go into a shop and you go, I'd love a gimp hood, but I'd like it with a sleeveless top attached? Hello? Look what I've got! Isn't that genius? And it's so warm. It's lovely. Are these machine washable, Manuela?
Washing by hand.
You've got to wash it by hand?
Yeah, yes, for about 2 days, I'd imagine. I'm imagining that you could leave a skid mark you couldn't take out with a fire.
Well, listen, I'm going to... Manuela, thank you very much. I'm going to try and get some people in our audience to model some of this stuff. So, first off, let's try and find a lovely lady. Now, I think this, I mean, that's quite revealing, but we'll be nice to you. Who'd like to try on this? Anyone do it? Oh, are you serious? Would you do it? No. Are you sure? You'll do it. But what's your name?
Sarah.
Sorry?
Sarah.
Sarah, are you sure?
Yeah, go on.
Okay, Sarah. And now I need this. You'll wear that. You've got to wear both of them. You going up?
Go on in.
What's your name?
Chris.
Chris? Okay, so Chris and you, you go up the stairs then. Go up the stairs.
Excellent.
First up, modelling, it is Sarah with a combination.
Oh, yes!
Oh, beautiful! Gorgeous! Come with me now. There's a little mark there. Strike some poses. Woo! Woo! Beautiful! Beautiful! Right, right, right. You want to walk off there? There goes Sarah. I'm going to spare her blushes. Now it's time for Chris in his Gimpy Nation thing. Well done, can you see there? Over you go. Oh, such a pose there. Well done. I wonder if he's really in there. Well done, Chris. Off you go. There you go. Someone come behind you. Ooh. Follow that with a song.
I know.
Imagine him just sitting down next to you on the train. Do you hear the football scores today?
It would be quite embarrassing for him if he found that the wool actually was something he quite liked.
He really liked.
You know.
He did look quite excited, didn't he? Wouldn't that be awful if he actually got an erection on television?
I know, it would be...
Awful, wouldn't it? Awful. Is someone out there? Do you go out with him? Used to. did you dump him in the last 2 minutes?
But this is the spin-off of your website, which is so incredibly successful.
Yes, no, it's been really well received. Actually, people like the website, which is really good.
So, sorry, because obviously I don't go on computer. what is the website?
It was a method of trying to set up my friends. I tried to fix them up with everyone I'd met, and they either had or hadn't done it, and then hate each other afterwards. And I'd run out of people to set them up with, and I thought, well, I need to get my friends' single friends to meet my single friends. So I thought, well, we'll all stick our single friends on a computer, on a website. Yeah. And my friend built the site.
Here it is.
Voila, like that.
Yeah. MySinglefriend.com.
Has it been very successful then? People got together. Yeah, in fact, when I was backstage just now, the lady who was doing sound said, oh, my best friend met her. She put her best friend on it, and she's met someone. And I kind of thought, oh, that's exciting.
But there is something slightly mysadloserfriend.com.
Well, a little bit, or perhaps it's more I'm a really meddlesome, interfering cow.
No, you're being Cupid. I like that.
It's very good sport.
Let's face the fact, Graham, and nobody knows this more than you, there comes an age when, frankly, you're not meeting lots of people at parties anymore.
No.
So the more help you can get, the better.
Yeah.
I love putting people together.
There we are, you see. It's the
love
of a
bit of match.
Okay, and anyway, let's put, I'm a male looking for, well, that would be a male. Hang on, let's go male. Let's go somewhere fun. Let's go to Clued. Okay, let's
see. There'll be lots here.
Clue. Sorry, there are currently no results in this particular story.
Oh, no.
Not even one sad gay man in Clues.
Yes, they're all living happily together.
They're running out. Well, listen, I'll tell you what I've done. Don't hate me for this. Neither of you hate me for this.
I already do, slightly.
I just wanted to see if it worked. That's all.
You've tried to matchmake us with somebody.
Well, I count you as a friend. Okay, you're not single, but for the purposes of this, you are.
Okay.
So I put up a description of you.
No, what have you said?
I didn't know how old you were, so I went for 33. I thought 33.
Thank you.
Yeah. looking for a male aged between 21 and 40, reckoning on me. You're in the London area, you are employed, you're curvaceous. Please go out with my friend Dawn, as she has fabulous breasts and will do anything for a chocolate on.
There's no denying that.
horribly true.
It does work. We got responses.
Did you? Right?
Now, some of them I can't show you on the television because I think some of them misunderstood. They thought you'd do anything with a chalky bone.
Oh, I really want to see that.
We don't have people like that on our side.
You do now. But no, we got two. Now, one in a picture. Can we show this? Oh, what the hell, we will. That's Darren. He looks so... He's 32.
He's straight.
Yes.
Oh, for change.
25 and 52. He doesn't care.
I quite like Darren.
Anyway, well, we tried to get in touch with him. He didn't play. Other creature with no photo, Peter, he did play ball with us.
When you say play ball, what do you mean?
Well,
am I married to him?
No. But we... this is bad. You're going to hate me now. But we'll make it up to him, I promise. We will make it up to him. We have arranged to meet him. And he's waiting at near the Millennium Bridge.
Okay.
To meet you.
Yeah.
So we can go now. We've got a camera. We've got to find Peter first. We have his phone number, so I can call him when we find him.
So he thinks he's on a date.
Now,
that's him.
Is that Peter?
That's my Peter.
He's not 32.
I've waited my whole life for you, Peter.
So the thing with that, no, they're women.
It's not
them.
Petra.
Anymore? Oh, there's a man. Another thing.
Oh, that could be Peter.
That could be Peter. Oh, look, he's drinking in the street. That's him. Ooh!
Ooh! Who's that?
Do you think it is?
He's lovely.
He's very nice.
Well, I quite liked all of the other ones. As well as this one, obviously. Is it Peter?
It's Toby Maguire! It's Toby Maguire!
Who's that?
I don't know.
Turn round, Peter.
Okay, I think your chances are... It's either the guy on the bench... Or it's this creature. Oh, no, it could be the sexy one. It could be the sexy one. OK, so listen, we'll now get a phone and find out. OK, so are we dialing, yeah? Oh, please ring.
Please
ring over here.
Please, Peter.
I don't know why, because it's your date, but still. It's ringing. It's ringing. Or maybe he's not there. Hello, is that Peter?
Hello, yes.
Hi, my name's Graham, and you're waiting to meet my friend Dawn?
Yeah, I am. She's a bit late.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I'm ringing because I'm afraid Dawn isn't coming.
Oh, you're fucking kidding me.
I'll be honest. Peter, this is Graham Norton on The Graham Norton Show.
You're all right, Peter.
No, what it is, I was just seeing if the website worked because the friend I was talking about was Dawn French.
Dawn French? I love Dawn French. She's amazing. I love her.
Calm down.
Peter, can you hear me?
Hello?
Hi, it's Dawn here.
Hi, Dawn.
Thank you so much for turning up for our date.
Yes, thanks for not turning up.
Well, listen, I'll tell you what, I've got an entire studio audience here, okay?
Yeah.
So I'm going to try and find you a date now. So here's the thing, we will pay for dinner. Well, we'll pay for the food, the wine, the legal fees afterwards. Everything. Oh, no, are you sending each other? Oh, is she the single friend? Who wants to go? You, the dark-haired lady.
Yeah, she looks lovely.
Ooh! Hello. Wait a second, lady. Lady, wait. Whoa. Stay. Good audience member. What's your name?
Sabelle.
Sabelle?
Yeah.
As in, give us a. Or, Peter.
Hello.
We're sending Sabelle. Sabelle.
Okay.
And she's lovely, Peter. I've just had a good look at her. she's good.
I think you'll like her.
Oh, yes. Is there a lot to like?
Oh, Peter. Are you a chubby chaser?
There is an ample sufficiency of Sabelle. She's lovely. All right, so you stay there and we'll send Sabelle to find you. All right.
Okay.
Bye, Peter.
Right, see you later. Sabelle, you go. We've got a car waiting and you can go and meet Peter. Genuinely nice.
Isabel
genuinely single? Yeah, she wasn't just going for the free dinner.
She said, yeah.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
I don't know, like, oh, God.
Sort of single. Yeah.
Or she killed her last boyfriend. Yeah.
Because if she's horrible to Peter, that's my Peter.
Oh, that's so romantic.
Yeah.
Is it?
Mm.
Okay.
Well, it's exciting, anyway.
No, it is exciting.
Yes.
I can't wait to see them together. The chemistry.
Yeah. Mm.
In terms of language, you know the way when you go to a country, sometimes you can know how to say hello and beer and taxi, things like that. This, I think, is a very useful book. It is the little book of essential foreign swear words.
Swear words, c'est des jurons. C'est ça.
She's just nodding. She's happy. So obviously there's your basic ones, like there's that and done.
Asshole, bastard,
bitch,
burger.
Oh, well, just stop before we get to C. We want to stay on air. But now what's weird is, I think, honestly, this must be for English people going abroad to just be vile. Like things like, I'm not making this, these are really in the book. These are phrases really in this book. Your country is like a toilet. It doesn't need a president, it just needs someone to flush all the shit away. Why did you go there on holidays? You can just imagine somebody from England going to France saying, look at this. Are you dribbling or do you have rabies?
C'est quoi rabies? Diarrhée.
Oui. Non, c'est...
Diarrhée.
Oui.
No.
La rage.
See, we should have gone with her. I knew we should have gone with her. Oh. Now, these are terrible. Imagine wanting to know this phrase. Right, you're on holidays. Here we go. I think I might have stepped on something unpleasant. Yes, it's your country. Terrible. Anyway, listen, very quickly, we have a website for the show, and thank you, everybody, for sending things in, and there's lots of ways for you to get involved on the website. But one of the things we do is we ask people, what are you doing tonight? Mm. So, because you're here, we thought we would go wine tasting with you. So I've got some glasses. That can be mine. Some glasses here for wine. There you go. So let's go over now to the wine tasting place.
Hello. Hi.
So who's in charge? Can I talk to the man in charge? Woman in charge?
Hi. Man in charge.
Hello.
I'm Francis. Yes. Hello.
You might be a lesbian. Now,
you can only see me from the top up. So.
He does look like Gilly Goulden, doesn't he? So I've got some of Gérard Depardieu's wine. Mm-hmm. Is that correct, Francis?
It is indeed. Lumière.
Due to the generosity of Mr. Depardieu, we are going to have a glass for everyone in the audience.
Thank you.
Yes. Now, can I say, I said wine tasting, not binge drinking. Okay. I'm worried now. They'll have a glass of wine, so the seats will be going around. All right. So if you can hang on, Francis.
I will. We'll hang on.
You hang on. We've got two glasses, so you can taste and then spit into the second glass. So I think we've got plastic glasses. They're coming out now. Now, by the way, no drinking it yet. No one drink it yet. You must wait. So, Francis, what do? I just pour a bit out, do I?
Oh, you pour a bit out. Only about that much. Don't give yourself too much. You don't want to overburden the glass. You need to
whatever.
Feel balanced.
Not too much.
Yeah. Half of you. Okay, half of you.
Like that.
Good. Okay. Some more. Okay, Francis, okay. We're loaded up.
The next thing you need to do is give the wine a little bit of a swirl.
Swirl? I think I know why you don't fill it up too much now.
Yeah. it takes a little practice. You can do it with either hand if you want. Whichever.
Yes, apparently I can.
You can or. There's a wine taster in you.
Now, what do we do? Do we gargle it and all that stuff?
Oh, you can gargle it if you want, if you've got something lodged in your throat. Because that's the only reason you should actually gargle a wine.
It's young, yes.
So, well, the next thing is well, I'd like you to think about inches here. And it's the distance your wine is from your nose when you can smell it. So, take it there, get your nose out, drift it to one side. Now, that's about 3 inches, I trust. Then try it. About an inch below your nose. About there. That's pronounced. The alcohol's just tickling your nose.
Spit. Spit.
Yeah, you shouldn't have drunk it.
And now.
You told me to drink it.
Right. Oh, yeah, just do it quickly. Okay. That's it. Put your nose in the glass. And try and snort a small amount up either nostril. If your nose is right in the glass, you have a wine with a low intensity. You have a very, very small nose there. So,
no, very small nose.
I'm not sure what you mean, John.
I'm saying. Oh, dear. Okay. Are we ready? Have we all smelt it?
Yes.
Or are we ready to taste it? Francis, are we ready to taste it?
I'm ready.
Okay. Yes.
Here we go. As one audience, here we go. What do you think? Go. And what's interesting is everyone swallowed. Not one person spat it out. It wasn't even an option. That is gorgeous.
It's a great one.
Oh, seriously, audience, I thought that was delicious. Yeah! Audience like, yeah! It could be Kansas Special Brewer, right? Yeah! Okay, goodbye, wine tasting people. Thank you very much. Good night. Bye-bye. That nice? Wait, don't put them on yet. No. Don't put them on yet. I'll go and find someone in the audience who has a question for Lisa about you.
Okay.
And then you have the headphones on, so you don't hear her,
so
you don't hear her answer.
Hair.
Yeah, you don't do that. Then you don't hear her answer. You hear her answer.
Alright.
And then she answers, and then we ask you and see if the answers match.
Alright.
See how that game works?
Yes.
Okay, so who has a question? Lady up here. Hang on. So stand up you. Okay, so Dustin, pop your headphones on. Pop your headphones,
headphones on.
Headphones on.
Yeah.
So Dustin, you're listening to music. Yeah.
What?
That's fine. Good. So you can't hear. Put them back on. Put them back on. Okay. What's your question for Lisa?
Who should play Dustin in a film of his life?
Who would he like to do that? No, it's fine. No, it's good. Well done. Beautiful.
Oh, he's cheating.
No, I'm not. Just Miko's looking down my wife's cleavage. Sorry.
Okay, back on. Okay, answer that. Oh no. You wait.
Oh God.
Who would he say?
Don't look. Brad Pitt.
Okay. Headphones off. Okay. The question the lady had was, who would you like to play you in the story of your life?
What a toughie. I don't have a clue. I don't have a clue.
Who do you think Lisa would think you would think?
The story is a joke. You mean like George Clooney or something?
Ooh.
or seriously? You mean seriously? The story of my life.
So you were very close.
Really?
You were very close.
Brad Pitt.
We'll do one more. Anyone else? Let's go.
So much sexier than Brad.
Yay! Who, you up here? Okay, headphones on. Okay, yep.
Lisa, what's Dunstan's worst habit?
His name's Dustin.
Dustin. What's his worst habit?
What does
what's his worst habit? What does he think, I guess? What does he think you'll say? Thank you.
Farting in bed.
What did you say? What did you say? What did you say?
Farting in bed.
Okay. Let's go.
Say you're gonna get you down.
It's me, Adam. Okay. Apart from singing, what is your most annoying habit?
Farting in bed.
Do you mind putting the headphones on for 1 second? Oh, yeah.
And there's a few men here tonight, right? Now I'm not the only one. You get up at night, she says, you get up during the night, you go to the bathroom, you take a pee, you come back to the bed, and then you fart. Why can't you fart in there? Am I the only one here that...
No,
and she says, it's offensive. She calls it microscopic shit. Yeah, sorry.
That's a window into your lives. okay, if you, you, know, you no, we're gonna do one the other way around. We'll just do one and then we're done. Okay, one question for Dustin about Lisa. Lady at the back there, okay.
Oh, get even.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, here we go. Okay.
Dustin, would you describe yourself in bed as a marathon man, little big man, or a rain man?
I mean, what I think she's going to say.
Yeah, what's she going to say?
Well, she's not going to say Rain Man. So it's Marathon Man who's, like, going in for a long time. I doubt whether she's not going to say that. What's the other one?
Little Big Man.
I'd hope she says that.
Okay, so you're going with that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Lisa?
Rain Man,
Lisa?
It's over.
How would you describe him in bed? Would you describe him as A, Marathon Man, B, little big man, or C, Rain Man?
Don't fuck me up. Be careful, I don't help you with your product ever again.
Marathon Man.
She was trying to pick you up there.
When's the last time I've gone for 26 and a half miles?
I didn't think of it literally.
The pleasure was endless. Yes. That's what it was.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what it was.
I picked little big man, bitch.
Why? Oh, no. They're about to have a fight. We're leaving it. The weird thing is, because, you know, when you search online for people who've taken selfies and stuff with your good self, Johnny Depp, it seems it's not that hard to look like Johnny Depp. And this is just, these are just...
Wow. That's a bold claim.
No, wait. Here's some people out for the night. Oh, my God! Just like Johnny Depp instead of a hot dog.
As long as she's happy. She's happy.
she's very, very happy. And obviously you're here to talk about Black Mass, which is terrific. And the thing is, in Boston, when you were there, it must have caused a sensation, but then double the chaos, because Benedict Cumberbatch, wherever you go, you have very ardent fans.
I agree.
I said I do.
Oh, yeah.
I said I do.
Yeah, you do.
By the medium of a gin and tonic, I said I do, yes.
And somebody saw Benedict on location in Boston, and we've got a picture of you on set that day. And so she saw Benedict and immediately rushed home and went on to Reddit. And she goes, I saw Boston Batch, because that's your name in Boston.
Yes, it's an adaptable surname.
Yes, I saw Boston Batch this morning. Bury me in a Y-shaped coffin, for I am deaded. So she writes... Bitches, he is fine. He was wearing a blue hat, a dark blue polo shirt. The grey pants and the white shoes. He's taller than I thought. I suspected he was about 5'11", wannabe 6-footer, but no, he's definitely 6 foot tall. And ripped. Really much more muscly than I was expecting. Those arms, dad ass. and the arm veins were in full effect, popping. There was not an ounce of fat on that man. It's all muscle, sinew, and wholesome goodness. And the hat looks better in real life, too.
But the what last was wrong with the hat?
No, no, the last paragraph, the last paragraph is, though, where you just kind of think, whoa. I couldn't smell him. I really tried. He was so close that had he been wearing cologne, I think I would have been able to tell. Just the lightest cumber musk in the Boston sunshine. Are you getting it, Tommy?
Cumber musk.
My musk in your general direction.
I gotta tell you, I can finally admit that I wrote that.
It's true.
My fucking veins and my arms and all.